So let's make a cool sidebar component for your cool side projects using only React and Tailwind CSS. We'll also make it completely retractable into a mini sidebar with floating labels on hover. So now that I've got you excited, let's build this thing. I'll wrap the sidebar with an aside tag having full viewport height. The main navigation will span the whole height with a background you want. Border right and shadow to make it look apart from the main content. I'll tell you why I made it flex in a moment. For the top branding part, give some padding, space between our logo and button and center them vertically. I'm using a dummy logo from logo ipsum and the button that'll later be used to retract this sidebar. And apply basic styles of a button. Now for the sidebar links that we will pass as children. To let it take the rest of the space, make it flex 1. That's why we made the nav flex. We'll get to the sidebar link component in a minute. Let's just finish this sidebar with the user section. Set it apart using border top. Flex to align its children in a row. Add the user avatar. I'm using a dummy one. You can set the width and height accordingly and make it fully rounded if you want. Separate the user info section. We'll be hiding it from the mini sidebar. Add space between and center vertically. I will use width 52 across the component. You can make this sidebar narrower or wider than this. And the name and email of the logged in user. You might want to decrease the line height a bit to make it look aligned. And finally, an action button that can be a logout button or a three-dot menu. And now on to the sidebar item component. It will receive an icon, text, active and alert props. We'll get to the last two props in a minute. Let's first pass in some sidebar items so that we can have something to look at. Make it relative, we'll see why in a minute. Center the icon and text vertically in a row with decent padding and margin in between each of them. Apply transition to colors that will change based on the active and hover state of the item. So when it's active, I want a subtle gradient background of indigo and text of dark indigo. Else on hover, background of light indigo and text gray. Set the same width and margin left for the text. So using the alert prop, you can guide the user's attention to a certain sidebar item by showing a small dot on the absolute right of it. Now our full side sidebar is complete. We can start working on its mini state. For that, we of course need a state. Let's call it expanded. On click of our button, toggle the expanded state. Based on that, we can show the appropriate icons. Let's start with the logo. To hide it, we'll transition its width property. Overflow hidden will prevent it from flowing out when its width is 0. When expanded, give it a width, else make it 0. and do the same with the user section below for its width and margin left. Now do the same for the links. We'll have to communicate the state to the children. Instead of passing it as a prop to each one of them, we can use a context to convey the expanded state. Wrap the children with the provider and pass in the state. Now we can access it inside the sidebar item. Hide the text similarly. And put the alert dot on the top right. One last thing left is the floating labels for the mini state. Make it a group since we'll be using the group hover variant. Absolute left full will align the text left and position it to the right. Now padding in margin left to space it from the sidebar's edge. It should only appear when not expanded. Set the background and text. Initially set it to invisible with 20% opacity and place a little to the left for the reveal effect to work. So on group hover, it will be visible with 100% opacity and placed in its original position. There you have it, your own custom sidebar completely built from scratch. I'll leave a link for this component in the description. If you found this helpful, leave a like and subscribe for more content like this.